already reached Metropolis.
Do you know where it started?
The small one. Find it something on one of Lex's computers. Then if anyone can figure out what it was, it'd be you.
Stay right there. I won't stand in your way. Don't want to hold you back if you're on the right path. Stay right there. I won't stand in your way. Don't want to hold you back if you're on the right path. They want to see you with a love forever. They want to see you with a love forever.
It's with an electronic virus and it's spreading faster than we can track it. After it scaled every firewall and knocked down all the communication, it's now infecting most of the city's infrastructure.
All because of me. Earth used to be sad. Now Fox's trying to force my hand.
Definitely playing hard. I mean, elevators, gas mains, subways, the entire city is shutting down.
You mean I'm some sort of alien?
No, of course not.
Mutant?
Yeah. Who has saved my life on more than one occasion? See, you've sort of taken it upon yourself to be Smallville's self-appointed hero. And if you ask me, I think that that is amazing.
Thank you. life support system. And that basically, in order to survive in our environment, we had to be born here in this human form. They must have come here in the past and obtained a DNA sample from a human subject. Now, since that birth, the being has grown exponentially. This is 1 hour after surgery. 3 hours. 6 hours. How much can you tell us about it? About it by decoding its DNA.
Oh, you don't understand. These are the Dead Sea Scrolls. Geneticists are going to be studying this code for generations.
No, they aren't. This code is the property of the U.S. government. Its very existence is classified. I want to see it.
These scrolls. Now, money really doesn't mean a lot to me. You know what happened? I was framed.
And you just happened to end up in this prison, in Lionel Luther's cell.
Oh. You must be Lex.
Lex? No, I'm not Lex. I'm Clark Kent.
He's good. We have a problem. He's scouring the globe, yeah. These ancient symbols, they've shown up in Egypt, Central America, even a sacred Indian cave right here in Kansas.
These symbols, they look like they mean something.
You better believe it. The mark, that means water. That's the element of, you know, transformation. How do you know that? Oh, you know, I've always kind of had a thing for pattern recognition, you know, codes and ciphers, that sort of thing. That one means fire, and the one up there, that's air. I take the three and put them together. My legend says that makes you to a trove of knowledge beyond your wildest dreams. I didn't believe any of this myself until 50 minutes of 14 seconds ago when a myth about body jumping was 50 came up.
Then who is controlling it?
It's not just a ship.
It's the brain interactive construct. An advanced technology that will stop nothing until its master, Zod, has been released.
No, there's got to be some way to stop him.
There is one way. There is one way. Zod was imprisoned in the Phantom Zone for crimes that led to the destruction of our planet.
Zod killed you.
And your mother. And our entire race. Just as he will do on Earth.
I won't let that happen!
Zod's physical body was destroyed to prevent him from escaping the Phantom Zone. He can be freed if he finds a body, a vessel to inhabit. Zod's physical body was destroyed to prevent him from escaping the Phantom Zone. He can be freed if he finds a body, a vessel to inhabit. You must find the human vessel and destroy it, no matter who it may be.
Clark, in certain cultures, when a father presents his son the gift of a knife, it represents a rite of passage.
How do you know this is from Jor-El?
The glyphs on the blade, they're Kryptonian. What does Jor-El want it to do with the dagger? Clark, I came here to find you. I woke up this morning, I found this. I must have written it in my sleep. Another warning from Jor-El. Tell me what it says.
Sacrifice the vessel.
Tell me what it says.
Sacrifice the vessel.
The vessel? I don't understand. Let me help you. Clark, please. You don't have to make this decision alone.
There's nothing you or anybody else can do.
Don't underestimate me, son. Clark,
best looks odd.
Lex? No, I'm not Lex. I'm Clark Kent. Houston, we have a problem.
Ignore the huge elephant named Clark in the corner?
And yet, wherever he's hiding, he chose to confide in the people that he trusts the most. And as much as I wish that I was one of those people, I can't hold it against you. I'm not going to ask you to betray Clark's secret if you'll stop denying that he has one.
Which we can't imagine.
the likes of which we can't imagine. And the place to find it is this island, a place where myth and science meet. It's a fairy tale.
Gary Truman didn't think so when he funded Monarch in 1946.
You know, in terms of sheer waste, Monarch ranks right up there with the search for alien life.
Yeah, but those guys are nuts.
We should have shut you down years ago.
This is an opportunity for our country.
Listen, Senator, let's have civic mission to the island. We could piggyback on that operation. With your permission, of course.
What do you hope you find?
Resources, medicine, cure for cancer, geological discoveries. I mean, possible alternate field, Senator. This is to be honest. We don't know for sure what's there. Okay, but I will tell you what we do know. Tomorrow night, the Russian NOVSAT passes over this sector, and in 3 days, they're gonna have the same images we have. So, whatever's there, you want us to find it first, right?
I don't believe I'm saying this, but that almost makes sense.
Thank you.
So, I will get the figure for you. I will. Listen to me. This is it. It's got to end. This is it. You promise me? Last favor? Okay?